instead of going that, maybe just try another semi-breathe over that silence on a D.
I kind of wanted the studio experience to be limitless. I didn't want to have to be thinking within constraints. Because I already think with constraints when I'm writing. So I didn't want to bring that into the production.
Oh dear. Yeah, that kind of thing.
Okay.
In unison, the three of you, if you can. And you learn that a soul has got to change. So you throw all your cards out the window. Ow! You carry on making it up on the way.
Every 2 days, we did a new song. We got them all to a point where they were, in certain cases, finished. And then there were about six tracks that we really needed live strings on. And then we had sort of 3 days at the end, right at the end of the recording, where we brought strings in, and then we brought a choir in for one track, just to get a bit of extra texture on the vocals. And then we finished, and then we were done. Then we had 1 day just to tie all those things up, and then whoa, all of a sudden we had a record. It's really important that the music live sounds like the record to me. At this first stage, for this first record, that's very important. I do value the art of a live show, the musicality of it, and the construction of the songs live. That kind of live experience, where as an audience member, you feel this kind of, it can be electric. Like it's being built in front of you. It's being made in front of you. It's good. It's enjoyable.
Paradise is somewhere where you and I belong.